Got beans, get beans. Birder Butter Beans Studio.
You know who it is.
Hey guys, it's Birder Butter Beans Studio. This is my Devlog video number 2 for my game Duck Hunting HD. In the last video, I was designing the ducks and their movement. I made a lot of progress. I lost a good amount of footage because I had to switch headphones and they weren't recording audio. So I'm just going to recap what I did. I added a normal duck. I added a blue duck, which gives more points. Actually, let me go ahead and assign the sprite just so I don't get confused. Okay. Yeah, so that gives more points. And then I also added a dog holding a dead blue duck, and then also a red duck. Red is the most points you'll get by clicking a duck and shooting on it. And then two more ducks. So we have a total of 2, 3, 4 levels, or yeah, 4 ducks that pop in. I added sound effects for the wings flapping, which loops, and then music when the dog picks up or he pops out of the grass to show the dead duck that he captured. I also added a little points indicator that shows how many points you get for killing a duck. We got this crosshair that follows the mouse. And then if you miss all 3 shots, then it says the bird flew away. So I'll show you what the gameplay looks like right now. I added some sniffing for the dog, then he barks. And then the round starts. So the hit meter, what this means is basically how much fill this is. It's up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ducks. You need to kill 6 ducks to beat the round. Eventually, I'm only going to add 2 rounds, so the second one you're going to have to kill all the 10 ducks on the screen. And actually clicking on them is pretty, you have to be really accurate with it. I normally just aim for the wings because I always get them that way. I missed, you see. But I added a muzzle flash. Alright, so let's get this bad boy. You gotta be really accurate. I already missed one shot, so you see I have 2 more. I got it. See, I have an animation before he dies. And then the dog pops out. So you got a blinking indicator to show what duck you're currently on. We're on the second one. We got a blue duck. It's worth more points. I got it. Worth 1,000 points. And we're on the third duck. I missed all the shots, even though it looked like I hit it. I mean, in real life, you'd have to be really spot on to kill a flying duck. I hit that. But that's all the ducks for right now that I have. There's 10 ducks in a round, so I just have to finish programming the code for them. Basically, it's just copy-paste, but I tend to look at the video for reference to see what round they're on and what flight path that the bird takes. That way I can just modify the animation. So they're on the fifth duck. It's a blue duck, and it was flying from the center to the left of the screen. I think I have an animation for that already. I didn't mean to hit play. I meant to hit play on the animation. Yeah, so I'm just gonna duplicate this blue duck. And then the animations, we're gonna duplicate Blue Duck 1. Call it Blue Duck 2. Blue Duck 1 dead. We're going to call this Blue Duck 2 dead. And then I have a little trick for duplicating animations and assigning them. So I click on this. I remove the current animator it has. And then this animation will disappear. I add an animator component. I create an animation. And then I'll just call it Blue Duck 2 underscore 1 because we're going to delete it and just use the animations that we have over here. So all I really want to do is just create the controller. Now it doesn't really matter. I can just delete. So I'm going to delete. And then we go to our duck. You notice it's missing. We go to the animator. We're going to rename this to Blue Duck 2. And then in this motion field, we're just going to drag the animation here. And it'll pop up. We're going to right click, create a state, create empty. And we're going to rename this to Blue Duck 2 dead. And then we're going to drag it from here. We got to create a bool called is dead. Right click, make a transition. And then backwards, uncheck on has exit time. Just do all this. Is dead is true. It should transition to Blue Duck 2 dead. And then just add false on the way back. Now I just want to animate the animation. So click on our duck. And I want to move it over here because like that's where it started from in the reference video. I'm going to copy the component because once I hit record, it's going to jump back to the other spot. And then I'm going to paste it. And it should like smartly tween to where it's supposed to go. Although I'm going to make some modifications and not have it go to the middle of the screen. Whoops. I want it to go like over here. Let's make it go here. Let's copy the component. Then once we get to this frame, we're going to paste it and then change the rotation to 0. And then he can just continue on his normal animation cycle. Yeah, that's basically it. That's what I've been doing. So now we just need to create some variables. So that would go after normal duck 3, would be blue duck 2. Also, we need an animator, so blue duck 2 anim. Also the button, that would be blue duck 2 button. What else? We need duck 5 clicked. Also, duck 5 flew away. So, I normally turn off the ducks when it starts in the start function. And then let's create the sixth. Blink duck hit. Well, might as well create all 10. But this is just a little animation for the icons down here to blink when it's the current round. It shows you what duck number you're on. could just do all 10. Okay, last one. Okay. So let's copy the code for click blue duck. The first blue duck that appears. We'll put it right after this. Click blue duck 2. So blue duck 2 anim. And then we're going to change this to blue duck 2. This would be blue duck. Duck 5 hit. So if we kill the duck, then the fifth duck should turn to the red sprite. This is blue duck 2 button. We disable the button once we click on it. That way we don't register a double click. This would be duck 5 clicked. That's basically it there. We just need to duplicate this coroutine. And name it blue duck 2. Basically the same code. We're gonna comment this out, but that would be the next duck to show right after you kill the second blue duck. So we're gonna show blue duck blink duck 6 hit. All right. Scroll down, and then there's an if statement that I need to copy. So this says, if you miss all 3 shots, then the bird will fly away. We need to do that for the duck that we just did right now. So this should be blue duck 2.setActive. So that's round 5. If you miss all the shots in the fourth duck that pops out, then the fifth duck will show. So if the current round is 5 and you miss all 3 shots, then blue duck 2 is going to turn off. The bird is going to fly away, so the panel will pop up and it says fly away. We're going to reset the current bullets to 3 and show all the bullets. Add 1 to the current duck num and then start the coroutine. Blink duck 6 hit. Play the sound of the flapping as well as the quack. So it's just a repeat process for all the other ducks that remain. There's like 5 more. We just need to assign some items in the inspector. So I'm going to go back to the canvas and it's going to say missing items or none. So blue duck 2 is over here. This is the animator. It's also the button. It's also a game object that we hide, and that's it. So we click play, and we should have five ducks to shoot. So this should be click normal duck 2, click normal duck 3, this should be click blue duck 2. It's the best sprite I could find for the dog jumping. I can never seem to hit it. Can't shoot before the round starts. I added that as well. There we go. The graphic didn't change. Also, the fifth duck is not showing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Click, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Normal duck 3. Oh, that's why duck 3 hit image. Just should be duck 4 hit image. Turns to the red duck. And carrying blue duck 2 Blue deck 1, orange deck 2, orange deck 3. Oh yeah, we forgot to turn this off. And that should be blue duck 2 dot set active. So now the fifth duck should show. Let's try again. So I'm gonna slow down the animation because there's a point where he just flies away too fast. No, it's not this one. It's the other blue duck. It's just ridiculous. See, like, right there? There's no way he can get to that point that fast, so... I'm gonna just drag all this to the right just to extend the animation, see what that looks like. Alright, so that's gonna need some duck flapping wings on every fifth one, so blue duck open, close blue, open blue, close blue. I'll just stick one here. This should be open blue. Close. Cool. Yeah, so it shouldn't be that crazy. Okay, that's better. So let's see what the sixth duck looks like. What color it is and how it flies. A normal duck. Let's see here, here. I'll literally just duplicate this one, I guess. I don't even have to make much changes to the animation. It's just a code, really. So here we go. Well, that's gonna be a problem. What controller is it using? Normal duck 1, which would have been normal duck 2. So I wonder if it's going to be a problem. I think we'll make it work, hopefully. I guess we'll add an if statement on the click method. So if current dot num equal one, two, three, four, then do this. And then 1, 2, 3, 4 by 6. We'll say carry dead duck 3. This is going to be duck 6. Okay. We also need to turn on the button because right now it's turned off. This would be duck 6 clicked. Where did that come from? This should be dead duck 4. Comment that out. Duck 7 hit. And then we gotta turn on the sprite or the button because it's disabled. That was like way up here. Like blue duck 2. carrying. We got two. Normal duck. Normal duck four. Also, oh, well, we did duplicate it, so we're going to need to create another button as well. Yeah, probably another animator too. Normal duck four. Normal duck four button. Normal duck four. Duck six clicked. Wow. Duck six flew away. That's actually normal duck four button. So, number five, one, two, three, four, five, normal duck, four, set active true. That's round six. Copy this. That should be six. Three, four, five. Six. This is normal duck four. We don't know yet. What's the next duck? That was five, that was six. This should be seven. And quick, so we save. And now we can just keep the same duck or the same click method because we added an if statement this time. And we'll just assign the items in the inspector. Cool, so now we have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ducks. Why is he showing? Because we didn't tell it to set active false in the start method. Blue duck 2. Normal duck 4. Okay. My advice is to shoot the duck when the wings are open. I think that's the best time to hit it. We just need 4 more ducks. Oh, great. I can just duplicate again. What is this one? So, normal duck 5. Normal duck 5 button. Duck 7 flew away. Or duck 5, set active false. Yeah, we gotta do this again. But for click normal duck 1. So if current duck num equals 1, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Normal duck. I have to keep counting. 4, 5. Duck 7. Normal duck, 5. And then we need another dog carrying dead duck. And we can turn this on. It's normal duck 5. This is carrying dead duck 5. Leave that commented out, and this is going to be number 8. And then the flyaway panel. We're going to uncomment this, normal duck 5. Copy it. Five, six. Seven, normal duck 5, fly away. Comment that out. That should be number 8. That's it. So we have 2, 3, 4, 7 ducks, and we just need to assign them again in the inspector. Did I save the script? Oh, I forgot to include normal duck 5 in the game objects. Duck 7 click doesn't exist. There we go, so now it should pop up. Let me see something. You can kind of see the dog's nose sticking out a little bit. think I should drag him down just a tad bit. And just copy that. Cord. Paste. I'll do the same thing with the other ducks. There. All right, so now it's not as annoying. All right, so we have about three more ducks to add. Another normal duck. This one's flying to the right this time, though. What do you know? Normal duck two. Duplicate that. And then let's do the variables again. So normal duck six and normal duck six button. Duck 8 clicked. Duck 8 flew away. I guess I didn't make a normal duck 6. In the game objects, nope. And the method it's using is normal duck two, right? So just another one of these. And that would be if current duck nom is 8. Normal duck 6 anim. 5. Duck 8. Normal duck 6, duck 8. Oh, wait, what? That's a 7th duck? I'm confused. Sorry, I was just really confused. I think I'm good. I just want to make sure the third one is clickable. Yeah, is this supposed to be 3, not 4? Yeah, that's probably why I wasn't able to kill it.
Ah.
one didn't work. Also, like glue duck too. All right, what's the stuff look like? A red duck? What's a blue one? Yeah, that'll do. Actually, this one probably, because the other one was further to the right. So that's our ninth duck. That's click blue duck, so. Blue duck 3. Blue duck 3 button. Blue duck 3. Duck 9 click. Duck 9 flew away. Deduct 3. Set active false. And then the method it's using is click blue duck, so click blue duck. The blue duck is number 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 2 and 9. Oh, 7, 8, this should be 9. That's 10. Last one is a normal duck. That'll do. So normal duck 2, we just need to add another method for current duck num equals 10. All right, that's all 10 ducks. Let's just test it to see if it works, and then we should be able to just save and we'll end the stream here. What's up with number 3? Seriously. Could that be why they're so hard to click? Just because the box collider is so small? I mean, it's the button I'm clicking on. Just check number 6 really quick. So got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just want to see if I can hit number 6. I'm good. try else ifs instead of ifs. I might need to change the other ones as well. Maybe that'll solve it. That's weird. Current duck number 11. Alright, well, I guess we'll just check this tomorrow. So I'm going to end it here. If you like the video, make sure to leave a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications, and I'll catch you in the next one.
You know who it is!